Hello fellow gamers and achievement hunters. In this video I want to show you a new card game, the Amazing American Circus. There are already a few card game videos on my channel like Slay the Spire, Monster Train, Banners of Ruins, but this game is quite different. It is not a roguelike card game. This is more like a campaign-oriented card game, and it include some financial micromanagement too. You need to organize your circus financially. So let's check the financial micromanagement part first, and the options of the circus. First of all, there are artists in your circus. These are the artists with cards. You will play with these during the, well, let's call battles or during the show. These artists get experience during the show, and you can also level them up at the training wagon. Well, I will show this level up a bit later, because Gypsy Bertha will reach the third level after the next show. You can also recruit different artists. There are 15 different artist classes, so there are a huge variety for the game. There are also a recovery wagon, because, well, during or after the shows, your artist could get gifts on the hoaxes. Well, hoaxes, that is like cures the cards, so negative effect cards, and you could remove these gifts and hoaxes in this recovery wagon. Well, your artist also have some traits. Sometimes you want to delete these or lock, because you can lock one trait. Your artist could lose traits or gain new ones after every show. So with lock, you can lock one of the traits of each artist, and that way they can't lose that trait. This is very useful if you want to lock one good trait, and you can also delete the bad traits you don't want on one artist. Of course, all these costs money. There is also a cookhouse wagon. Well, you can craft some food here. Food is used during traveling. There are few stats. You can see here this three different. During traveling, you losing these traits, but with food you will also recover some, and you need to balance these traits during traveling so none of them goes to negative, or eventually you want to boost one to get some bonus related to that traits. There is also a bizarre bazaar. Well, I have only one misfits unlocked. You have only one at the beginning of the game. After 3 hours of gameplay, I still not managed to unlock any other. This unlocked usually by finishing some quests. I finished some already, but those awarded artists so far only. And here's the Ringmaster cart. Here you can upgrade each wagon with additional abilities. Now during the shows you can earn money, and here is the map. You need to finish shows in each city. With that you get some fame. With fame you can unlock the other parts of the United States. And for money, you can also discover additional locations, because there are hidden locations on the map. For example, for 75 American dollar, I can discover this region. And now I can travel to Salem. And when you click on cities, you can see it here, audience. This means the enemy type or audience type you will encounter in that city. I will talk about that a bit more during the show I will show you soon. But each city has different enemies, audience, so this increases the variety of the game too. Now let's return to my city and let's start the show. Well, from your artist you need to select three performers. These will be your characters during the, well, let's call it combat. And you also need to select one misfit and one finale. I will talk about this later during the show. And here you can see the enemies, the audience. Let's go to the ticket. Well, you can boost your income here with some promotion. And let's start the show. So during the show, you will have some cards. Each of your character has five different cards. When your artists don't have health points, this 12/12 represents the focus of your character. If they get so-called damage, then they losing this focus. If they run out of focus, then they not going to die or such thing. They will lose one card for the show. If that happens, then their focus will be refilled, so it will be on 12 again. But in the card pool, that character, that artist will have only 4 cards. You have a total of 15 cards, but if your deck running out of cards, then each of your artists losing 5 focus, and that is when you can get your cards back from the discard pile. So this gives some time pressure on each show too. Okay, now let's talk about the audience first. These 15 points isn't a head point error, this is a boredom. You need to kill the boredom so they will enjoy the show. And the damage is usually throwing the tomatoes or other actions which decrease the focus of your artist, and they will do additional stuffs too. So let's start the game. For example this one will add 3 focus on one of the characters. You can see 2 different numbers on this card. This is the vitality is the resource you have. This is the cost of the cards, and this is this blue stuff is the final. Yeah, if you play a card with 1 final point, then this bar starts to get filled. If you reach 20, then you can play a final, and it will actually do 15 impressions, so to a random enemy, a random audience. So that could make one miner happy if the miner is selected. You will have some card which increase ignore. Ignore is actually an armor that negate the damage your artist could get to their focus, but eventually you can use that focus to use it to as damage. For example, I will turn that that 10 ignore to 5 damage on the mind foreman. If you don't have any vitality, you can click next turn, and that is when the audience will have some actions. It is a bit different to other card games because you can see what kind of action will the enemy have during the next turn. Impress is the word used for damage in this game. Well, this is actually with this ability, this mind foreman will heal 15, but the X's boredom will turn to ignore, so that is not good for us. Of course, you would say that right now I should damage the miners instead, but the minor foreman has an annoying ability. He will make the miners bored again. And this is what I was talking about. My fire eater lost the full heart already, so I need to remove one of his card, where it should be. This is why was focus important. This artist, the Fire Eater, has a cool card with highly increased damage. For example, if she has only 6 health points, she has 6 health points missing, then the damage of this card will be increased by 6 damage. So instead of the 3 impression, it will impress with 9. And as you can see, the final bar is already filled, so I can use this now. It will do 15 impression to a random enemy. And it damaged the mine foreman. That is cool, actually. That is the most important to kill the first time. And no, actually, I can do any damage, but they will do some damage. So, well, let's use an ability which increases the ignore of all characters by 6 points. And I can't do anything more during this turn, so let's go to the next turn. And my Fire Eater lost the full health again. That is pretty annoying. Looks like I selected a bad... No, I was wrong. So the cost of the card of this juggler was more, but was increased because of a debuff, not because some trait. So it would be now pretty important to kill this mine foreman. So the enemies will do many things during the next turn, but there will be only one damage that would kill my juggler. So let's build up some ignore on that character. And now let's kill the mine foreman so he can't resurrect the miners. He just sit down, so he's not happy. Hooray! Okay, the bot enemy will damage my juggler, so I need to build up some ignore on that character. Actually, they will kill my enemy anyway, so they will do 16 damage. I could ignore only 9, so the character will die anyway. That means just better to use a damage ability on the enemies or the audience. Well, no time to remove one card again. And now the deck shuffle happened, so I will lost another card on the juggler. As you can see, you will have less and less cards, so the deck shuffle will happen sooner and sooner. That will damage each artist by 5. So the time pressure is existing during each show. It would be nice to kill one enemy again. Or bot. Ah, I can kill bot because this finale will damage one random enemy by 15, but I can kill this one which has only 2. Boredom. So this was one show. Of course, later levels will have more acts, so you need to pass more round, and it will be harder. There are 15 different artist types, so the variety of the cards is pretty high. And once we won a show, enjoy the money income, and let's level up the juggler. Yes, my juggler reached the next level. I earned some cash I could use for many different things. And I unlocked a new misfit. Snake Woman. Begging of the act, extra ignore. That is actually pretty useful. But it will affect only one random artist, just like for this one. Okay, so let's level up this Gypsy Berta, my juggler. It also costs money. And well, you can actually have some random effects what will happen during the level up. You can reroll it once if you unlocked the upgrade for the card, or you can select one if you happy with the reward or the card upgrade you could receive. This is actually a good one. It increased the increased damage of the card from 2 to 4. I am happy with that one. So that this way you can improve your artist. So this is actually the Amazing American Circus. Again, this is not a roguelike game. It is a campaign-oriented card game, but it is actually very unique. It brings some difference and something new to the card game. It plays from a new perspective. Well, and because I'm an achievement hunter, let's talk about the achievement in a few words. The game has 61 achievements, but I earned already quite some. From the ones I earned, I could have some prognose about the difficulty of the perfection. I believe mostly these are awarded for getting fames, finishing quests, so the perfection not looks difficult at all. Of course, achievements still hidden for me because the game is not released yet, so this is not exactly, I'm not exactly sure about the perfection difficulty yet. So please check the description, join my Steam, follow my Steam curator, and you will be seeing the notification, the new creation about the game. When I will finish it, I will add the perfection, accepted perfection time, or you can check, see that also on my Twitter. So please follow my Twitter, Steam Curator, and YouTube if you like this video. Thanks for watching my video.